Earnhardt has grown up for our very eyes. At just 4 years old, the New York native starred in her first commercial,
but
it was her roles in TV shows like Clarissa Explains It All, Sabrina the Teenage Witch, and Melissa and Joey that made her a household name.
In her latest project, Melissa pulls double duty as actress and director TV movie The Santa Con, where she tries to set her brother and his friend straight. Take a look.
What is he doing here? Better yet, what is his suitcase doing here?
Here's the thing. He's been staying at the Y for the last few days, and we thought he could save a little money if he just came.
Oh, so you think I'm running a halfway house for you and your convict friends?
Bro.
No, no, no. Why don't we just open a methadone clinic in the basement and I can sell hot TVs out of the attic? How would that be?
How would that
snappy
be?
Conversation.
I got to play a really fun character in this one, but I was so busy with the directing part of it, I didn't really, you know, it was my directorial feature debut.
Right?
Yeah, feature. I've done my shows before. I've done Sabrina and Melissa and Joey, and but this was different. This was storytelling, and this was like, you know, my ship to run.
And how did you find the experience?
It was the anxiety before we actually got to camera was almost killed me, and then once we actually started filming, I remembered what a blast I have directing and how much I love it.
So when you're in a scene like that one we just saw, mm-hmm. how are you directing it while you're in it?
Well, I've already set up the shots. I've worked with the DP, who's also in this case the camera operator, and we've set, you know, the shot and know what we're looking at. I have my sister as a stand-in, so she looks like me, and you know, so I've seen what it looks like, and now I just have to pop in, and I get to see the performances face to face. So, you know, I know the performances are good, well, at least the other besides my own.
Yeah.
But my mother's always my executive producer. She executive produced Sabrina and Melissa and Joey, and she executive produced this, and so I know that she's keeping an eye out too.
But how did you turn out so normal?
Yes.
I wrote a book because you asked me that last time, and I was like, I need to write a book to tell Kathy Lee how I ended
up so normal. We see all the train wrecks that happen with these kids that start
so early.
But those
are the ones we hear about, I think,
but
you know?
What do you think your parents did right? Like, I think they gave
us a loving household that wasn't about the industry, that was about go ride your bike, go outside, drink water from the hose, you know? It wasn't like, I also didn't grow up in L.A. in Hollywood with red carpets and that kind of thing. I was on Long Island.
Makes a big difference.
Yeah.
But so was Lindsay Lohan. She grew up on Long Island.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
But I think it was a different time, too. She came a little bit later when there was a lot more, you know, there's a lot more pressure on girls to have a clothing line and a perfume and, you know,
and naked pictures.
Yeah.
By the way, I feel like I see you a lot now because those Walmart commercials are everywhere.
I don't even watch TV, and I see it all the time.
How
I turn
did that
on the
come
TV
about?
The day to TiVo.
Yeah. You're with Anthony Anderson.
Yeah, who's on Blackish right
now.
He's a blast. We've had a great time, and we just shot our last few the other day, and I'm going to miss him if we don't do any more stuff.
Well, I think they were very successful.
They were. We did 45 commercials, plus not including the 5 Peter Pan spots I did with my family. So.
Yeah, and those ended up being a huge hit.
So you and your
kids and your husband?
Me and my 3 kids and my husband, and I guess the big Twitter question was, are those really your kids? And because of that, like, casting people have been calling for my kids and some of
them.
How are you feeling about that?
I don't know.
Same road you went down.
You know, but it's very flattering to hear that, you know, someone thinks your kids are talented or cute or whatever,
but at
the same time, I'm like...
And their ages again, for people who don't know?
Two, six, and eight. Tucker, Brady, and Mason.
Now, how's Christmas shopping going, by the way,
Oh, my
for
gosh,
you?
It's so crazy, because it's like, my husband and I, he gets crazy. He wakes up in the morning with his coffee and his Amazon. He's like online, like trying to online shop, and he's getting things shipped to the house, and we celebrate Christmas somewhere else than we live, so he's always like sending stuff, and I'm sending stuff, and then we go shopping together, and at the end of the year we're like, we haven't really gotten anything, and then we get there and we're like, we unwrap everything, we're like, holy moly, we've gotten them every single thing.
Yes.
Not to mention Walmart has sent them every toy that exists.
Oh, my God. You know what? I'm not going to tell you what to do, but what would be lovely is if you took them to a shelter for other little kids.
We are. We're taking them. Well, we're taking the kids on Friday. We're going to go serve the homeless dinner.
Perfect.
But Walmart actually donated all the toys we used on the set to my favorite charity.
Oh, that's awesome. Perfect.
So,
everybody
all
wins.
All the clothes, everything.
Great.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for being with us. We love seeing you.
Mm-hmm.
The world premiere of the Santa Con is December 13th on Lifetime.
Well, you met the finalists in the search for America's kindest kid.
Now-